everyone, thanks for tuning in. You just saw me playing Electric Gypsy by Laguns, and wow, what a tune. It is such a classic track. It's from the debut record coming out in 1988. It has Tracy Guns shredding all over it. If you want to see my full cover, you can check it out up here. And yeah, there's so much to talk to, so let's get right into it. So the song itself is not too tricky, so I'd give it a rating of 3 out of 10. There are some trickier bits in between, but if you have your left and right hand coordination solid, then that shouldn't be a problem for you. And we start off with the intro riff, which goes like this. So what I'm doing here is I play the open A string, like that. And then I play the D power chord, which is the D and B, D and G string on the 7th fret. And then I go back to the open A. Just like this. And then I play this little pull-off lick, which is the 9th fret G string pulling off on the 7th fret G string. And then playing the D 7th fret in between. Just like this. So we have. And then we repeat the same thing, but this time not play the D power chord, but instead a C power chord, so that's 2 frets below on the 5th. And then we do the same pull-off lick, but this time pulling off from the 8th fret B string to the 7th fret B string, and playing the 7th fret G string in between. And it doesn't really matter which fingers you use. I use, for this bit, I use my ring finger. You can also use your middle finger, and for the other bit I use my pinky, but you can also use your ring finger. It doesn't really matter. Whatever works, works, and yeah, do what you feel most comfortable with. So the whole intro riff sounds like this. And you just repeat that 4 times, and then it goes straight into the verse. Now for the verse, we just basically chuck along on the open A string. Just like this. So play the open A string, and then for this little turnaround lick, we go from the 5th fret A string to the 4th fret A string and back to open. And depending on how good your coordination is, you can either do pull-offs or you can actually strum every note. I personally do pull-offs because that just feels more natural to me. And also the 16th notes here, they should be more or less of a starting point. I sometimes change up the rhythm a bit, just however I feel comfortable. And you can also experiment with doing some little variations in it. I think Tracy himself encourages it. So what I did in my cover would be this. You know, just playing a few harmonics in there because I always thought it sounds cool. But anyway, this is basically all you need to do for the verse. So pretty simple, pretty straightforward. And let's carry on to the chorus. Now the chorus, we have this. So as you can see, it's very, very easy. What we do is we play an A power chord, open A, and then on the 3rd fret we play the G power chord, but I play it as an octave, which is this. So it's 3rd fret on the E string and 5th fret on the D string. And then we just go down chromatically to the F sharp and to the F. So. And that's all there is, and we do this 3 times, but on the final time round, we actually play the power chords. So like this. This is just something I also picked up from Tracy himself, because he said that gives the listener a guidance that we are going back into a different section. And you know, sometimes it's these little things that can actually carry a lot of momentum. But anyway, that is basically your chorus. And there's only one final section I want to talk to you about, and that would be the bridge section. Now the bridge section goes like this. Now this is a bit trickier, and you know, at that speed may be something that you need to practice, but actually, again, not too hard. So what we do, we play the A power chord, have that rest, and then we play this melody lick here, which is, I play the open E, going to the second fret, which would be an F sharp, and going back to open. And then on the A string, I go from 3rd fret to 2nd fret to open. And both combined would be. So. Going to the G power chord. Play the same lick again. And then going to an F power chord. I actually only play the F note. And then we play an ending lick starting on the low E string, going up chromatically to G. And then we play a little hammer-on pull-off lick at the end, which goes like this. Which is hammering on the open E string to the 3rd fret, and then the open A string to the 3rd fret. And then pulling off the 2nd fret G string to open. And a 2nd fret D string to open. And that's all there is for your bridge riff or bridge section. And that's all there is I want to talk to you about in this lesson. So now you can play Electric Gypsy 2, and I wish you a lot of fun with it. So guys, that's it. That was my lesson showing you how to play Electric Gypsy by the LA Guns. Now, I hope you enjoyed it, and as always, if you did, then do please consider to like my video, and also maybe to subscribe to my channel would be very nice. And yeah, that also gives me motivation to carry on and to do new videos. And yeah, let me know in the comments if you have any suggestions, and just tell me how you like everything so far. I'm very anxious to hear from you. And until then, I'll see you in the next one.